It's beautiful, isn't it? Yes. This is a forest in Nanaimo. What I've decided to do today is a bit different than my normal webcam podcast thing. See, it's going to be very weird me holding this thing. It's like, whoa. Anyway, I'm going to show you around town a bit. Some of my favorite spots where I've developed some of my most heinous, what do you call them? Plans. My schemes. Hang on, I'm sorry. I'm not used to holding a camera and filming myself at the same time. So, as you can see, we have a nice little forest here. The road is right there. And we have some garbage, and I think that's actually a, is actually a fucking, what do you call those? Shopping cart. It's a shopping cart. Yes, it's a shopping cart. And what I'm going to do is a bit like Survivor Man, but I'm not going to show you every second of my travels, okay? I'm just going to show you what I think is interesting and just take you to some different spots. So this is just off of Departure Bay. I don't know what they call this. But yes, we're gonna go roam around town and do some diabolical things, okay? So I just thought I'd give you this little update as a first, and then I'd go on, and then we'll continue our adventure, and I'll add in some like nice shots to kind of fade in between, okay? Okay, good, good, good. We'll go down to this creek in a bit. I'll show you the creek, okay? Is it centered? 3, 2, 1, action. Now the thing about traveling around in the woods, I just noticed this when I was walking down the when I was walking down to this creek here. It's probably not a good idea to be wearing a mask because it definitely hinders your vision. You want to have your vision perfect from below. You want to watch where you're stepping. And also, you want to make sure that no branches hit you in the face from above, okay? It's a big secret, and it's very dangerous because if you get knocked out by a branch, you could find yourself being eaten by a cougar, or a bear, or a deer, or a raccoon, or a fox. Anything. You do not want to fall asleep in the forest. That is rule number one. Anyway, I'll switch this this angle here. Excuse the bumps, those little clicks. It looks a lot better off camera, but it is a nice little creek. It goes down. It goes way down. It kind of reminds me of Lord of the Rings in that shot right there. It's kind of nice. This is what walking around. Oh dear. This is what walking around in the forest looks like from my view. This is Aztecoon Vision! Anyway, we have a little... Oh! Get that. Looks like we have ourselves some pollutant. Some angry kid got angry at his happy face ball, as you can see. I'm pretty sure you can see it's a happy face ball. And he decided to throw it on the ground here. Now, that's disrespectful to nature. Mother Nature doesn't like it when you put plastic things in her yard. And as you can tell, you can spot this thing from a mile away. So, it's pretty dangerous. Yes. Let us continue our trek. Climb up this, oh, it feels like I'm playing a Let's Play, but in real life. Yes, I don't know how far I'm going to take you up this creek, but I may decide to stop with the creekage, but, I will come up to this yard here, show you a bit about, whoa, that's a big step. What nature looks like against humanity. Looks kind of odd to me. Anyway, we'll move on. Now, the thing about walking beside the road, there's a lot of cars, you see. Sorry, somebody just honked at me and they thought it was funny, and I thought it was funny too. The thing about walking around the road is that if you're not careful, and by that I mean if you are drunk, it is a high possibility that you could fall over. And you could fall over straight into a car. The roads are pretty busy here, at least the main ones. So what you want to do is to avoid these things. Hey, that car's for sale, nice. You want to avoid those things if you're walking beside the road. What helps a lot is this white line here. That legally helps the... Uh-oh. My mask just came undone. Excuse me a second. I don't know if you can see that very well. But this has got to be my favorite place. It's Green Leaf Place. Now literally, that is what it's called. I don't know why they call it that, probably because there's an entire park surrounding the area. It is a very nice park, and it's so nice in fact that I spent quite a lot of time in there smoking the green leaf, if you know what I mean. And it's a public park, well it's a public trail really. The trail is only like, I don't know, a 5-minute walk, but there's quite a lot of nature in there besides it. Sorry, I'm holding my hoodie. It's quite windy today. I didn't choose the best day, and I don't want my hair sticking out in the wind. People might identify me. But what was I saying? Yes, we're gonna come to this park. I don't remember what it's called. It's like, it's some creek park. Creek, not Greek. It's starting to rain too. It's not a very nice day out. It's quite discouraging. With the wind and all, I don't know if it'll pick up any noise. Oh, here we go. This is the entrance to the park. It's quite lovely.